Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman delivered a marathon budget 2020 speech running more than 2 hours. We bring you 12 big takeaways that you need to know. Number 1. New tax slabs. Yes, there's been a big overhaul in income tax slabs. So if you're scampering for chartered accountants, we are not surprised. Sitharaman has proposed a new tax regime and made it optional for taxpayers to either switch to the new one or stay put in the old regime. If you were to choose the new tax regime, there's a conditions apply that you cannot afford to miss. You need to forego 70 out of the 100 existing tax exemptions under the new regime. These include standard deduction, house rent allowance, etc. Number 2. Sale of LIC. In an extension of its disinvestment pitch, the budget proposed to sell part of its holding in the LIC through an initial public offering, that is IPO.
The government now proposed to sell a part of its holding in the LIC by way of initial public offer.
Number 3. Simplified GST returns. Sitharaman, in what could be seen a big relief for traders, has promised a new simplified GST return regime from April 2020. What this would entail, we would have to wait and watch. Number 4. More secure bank deposits. Against the backdrop of the PMC bank scam, this could be seen as a big positive step for bank depositors. The insurance cover for bank depositors has been raised from 1 lakh to rupees 5 lakh.
This August House should know that robust mechanism is in place to monitor the health of all scheduled commercial banks and that depositors' money is absolutely safe. Further, the Deposit Insurance and Credit Guarantee Corporation has been permitted to increase deposit insurance coverage for a depositor, which is now standing at 1 lakh of rupees to 5 lakh per depositor.
Number 5. New education policy. The finance minister said the government will introduce a new education policy soon after it received over 2 lakh suggestions for the same. 99,300 crore rupees is the budget for the education sector, and another rupees 3,000 crore is earmarked for the skill development for next fiscal year. Number 6. Ayushman Bharat expanded. The centre has proposed to expand the Ayushman Bharat scheme with an allocation of rupees 69,000 crore for the healthcare sector, marginally up from last year. Among other things, Sitharaman said her government would launch a campaign to eliminate tuberculosis by 2025. Decriminalizing offences under Companies Act. Tax harassment won't be tolerated, Sitharaman said in her budget speech. She announced a taxpayer charter to make laws in order to assure taxpayers against harassment. The proposal to decriminalize offences under the Companies Act was made to respect wealth creators, she said. Number 8. Allocation for SC, ST and OBCs. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman announced allocation of rupees 85,000 crore for SCs and OBCs and rupees 53,000 crores for STs. What do the Kisans get? Sitharaman mooted a 16-point plan to revive agriculture and allied sectors and announced funding allocations totaling over 4 lakh crores for agriculture and rural sectors. Out of this, rupees 2.83 lakh crore will be allocated to agriculture, while rupees 1.23 lakh crore will be provided for rural development and Panchayat Raj. New airports and railways. As far as infrastructure is concerned, the finance minister announced that 100 new airports will be built and the fleet of commercial airplanes will be doubled by 2024. An overhaul in the railways has also been announced, with Sitharaman announcing that as many as 1,150 trains will be run in PPP mode and 4 stations will be redeveloped. Number 11. Women. The government proposed a task force to revise the legal marriageable age of women, which currently stands at 18. Her claim that Beti Bachao Beti Padhao has seen tremendous success was met with quite an uproar in the parliament. A sum of over rupees 30,000 crores has been earmarked for the Women and Child Development Ministry for the next fiscal year, a 14% increase over the 26,184 crores allocated to it last year. A major chunk of the sum, that is rupees 20,532 crores, is for Anganwadi services.
Women's age of marriage was increased from 15 years to 18 years in 1978. by amending erstwhile Sharda Act of 1929. As India progresses further, opportunities open up for women to pursue higher education and careers. There are imperatives of lowering MMR, maternal mortality rate, as well as improvement of nutrition levels. Entire issue of about age of girl entering motherhood needs also to be seen in this light. I propose to appoint a task force that will present its recommendations in 6 months' time.
Startups. Terming startups as engines of growth, Sitharaman said the present ESOP taxation leads to cash flow problem for the employees who do not sell shares immediately and continue to hold the same for a long term. The budget proposes to ease the burden of taxation on the employees by deferring the tax payment by 5 years or till they leave company or when they sell their shares, whichever is earliest.